Ah, Jimbo, I'm so bored. What is there to do on a boring Sunday like this? What? Go hang out with SpongeBob? Ah, Jimbo, I already told you, SpongeBob said he's busy today. I don't know what he could possibly be doing. I mean, it's Sunday, it's supposed to be his day off. He shouldn't be going in at the Krusty Krab. What? Read? Jimbo, like, books? No, I can't read these books, Jimbo. You should know these are only here for decoration. No, I know I'm not gonna like reading, Jimbo. No, no, no. If I wanted to see a good story, I would just see the movie, Jimbo. I mean, look at some of these titles right here. You got Hunger Games, Harry Potter. Yeah, for both those, I could just go see the movies, Jimbo. What's the point of reading the books? Oh, ooh, who could that be? I don't usually get visitors here, so this is a nice surprise. Oh, well, 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 look who it is, Mr. Busy Pants. Oh, Jack, you have to help me. I don't know, SpongeBob. You told me you were busy today doing something, and it's something that's not hanging out with me. And now I've just been sitting here on my rock today, all bored and lonely, just talking to Jimbo. Why should I help you? Please. I'm sorry I haven't done anything with you today, but I have a good reason. Oh, yeah? And what is that reason? I got a new French horn. So I've been trying to learn it all day. And failing, I might add. It's just so hard. I thought when I got it that all I'd have to do is blow into it, but apparently it's a lot more complicated than that. Why would you buy a French horn? You're not a musician. Well, I saw Squidward playing with his clarinet the other day, and it got me wanting to learn an instrument. I mean, Squidward's so good with his. I just want to be able to make music like he can. Anyway, that's kind of why I need your help. See, I was practicing my horn outside my house earlier, and Squidward came over and stole it from me. He said I was being too loud. I told him I would play it inside, but he didn't care. Just said that I shouldn't be allowed to touch instruments ever again. So, what do you want me to do? Well, I would really appreciate it if you could help me get the horn back. Squidward locked his door, so I can't even get into his house to talk to him. Plus, he's mad at me, so he probably won't even listen to me anyway. Alright, well, if the door is locked, how do you expect me to get in? I mean, it's not like I have a key or anything. I bet you can get in through the windows. They look pretty breakable. Alright, SpongeBob. Well, I guess I could try that. But if I do this, we're doing what I want for the rest of the day. Okay? No exceptions. So if I want to go and do some jellyfishing, that's what we'll do. And if I want you to go and make me a bunch of Krabby Patties and just sit there watching me eat, that is what we'll do. And if I want to just sit here at my rock doing nothing, and you just sitting there also doing nothing, then that is what we're going to do. Okay? Deal? Of course. Anything you want, buddy. Alright. I like the sound of that. Okay. Alright, well, if I'm going to try to break in through his windows, I'm going to need my tools. Thankfully, I've got all the tools I'm going to need right here. Ah, yes. Good old trusty baseball bat. And you never know, I might need some blocks. Alright. Let's go see what I can do. SpongeBob, it's a good thing you have a good friend like me, buddy. Alright, well, I see a small window right there. Oh, there's no way I'm going to fit through that. I'd assume that the easiest window for me to fit through would probably be the one right over here on the side. Yep, just like that. Alright, just got to pull out my trusty baseball bat, and alright, making progress here. Alright, almost. What the? Almost inside, but what is this block right here? What is this material? I don't even know what this is. It's definitely not glass. It's definitely not part of his windows. Did Squidward barricade his windows so that I couldn't break in? Ah, Squidward. Ah, you sneaky. Ah, you sneaky squid. Okay. Fine. I can't break in through that window. Can't break it through the window on the other side. I guess that just leaves, yeah, the two windows up top. The eyeballs of his house. All right, well, let me just make sure that his door is actually locked before I go building up into his windows up there. Yep, locked. All right, well, I guess I don't have a choice at this point. I'm gonna hang out with SpongeBob today. This is something I'm gonna have to do. All right, well, I guess I've broken into the Krusty Krab before, so I guess I have experience with this kind of work. Alright, I'm getting kind of close. And well, I can almost jump to his nose, and ah, perfect. All right, now I just have to climb up here and place one more block there, and all right, perfect. Ah, he didn't barricade these windows. Excellent. All right, so now all I gotta do is break through these windows, and voila, we're in. All right, I gotta make this quick, and I gotta be quiet about this too. I don't want Scooter knowing I'm in here. I'm probably gonna have to also pay for these windows at some point whenever I get a job and some money. But I can't worry about that now. I gotta worry about SpongeBob's French horn. Huh, I guess this is probably his music room, right? He plays his clarinet up in here. So maybe he's keeping it in one of these chests. Nope. Not anywhere in here. Maybe... Nope, not underneath there. Oh, dang it. I'm gonna have to check out the rest of his house. Alright, I'm gonna have to be very, very stealthy with how I approach this. I don't want him knowing I'm in here. Okay. Where'd he keep the French horn? Maybe in his closet right here? Nope. Maybe between all of his books? Nope. Why does he even have this many books? I can't imagine someone wanting to actually read all these books. Ugh, disgusting. Alright, well, maybe in here? Nope. That's a perfect spot, right out of reach. Nope. I think that's his bathroom. I don't want to go in there. How about downstairs? Maybe he's keeping it right down here. Oh, well, there's the barricade that he put up. Alright, I guess I can't blame him for that. I mean, I did try to break into his house, so I guess he was thinking ahead. Where else could he have the French horn? There's no other chest down here. And that's his front door. Oh no, he must be keeping it in his bathroom for some reason. Oh, and I haven't even seen him anywhere throughout the house. So unless he's gone... Oh no, he must be in the bathroom! Okay, well I guess I'm gonna have to check there next. Unless, maybe, hopefully it's underneath the bed? No, he doesn't even have underneath the bed. Okay, fine. I'm gonna have to go into his bathroom, see what's going on in there. Alright. Alright, please don't be in there, please don't be in there, please be gone for a second. Well, this is kind of awkward. Hey Squidward, didn't mean to, interrupt you, while you're trying to take a bath. Ah! Jack! What are you doing here? I'm trying to have my bath in peace! Look, Squidward, I'm sorry to bust in like this, but I just want SpongeBob's horn back. Once I get the horn, I'll be gone, ASAP. What? That idiot thinks he's getting that horn back? Well, he can keep dreaming. I'm gonna hold on to that forever. Wait a minute. How did you even get into my house? I swear I locked the door and barricaded the windows. Well, I kind of broke in by destroying one of your front windows. See, you didn't barricade all the windows, so there was still one of the windows in the front that I could break through, you know? But don't worry, because I will be paying you back at some point. I just have to get a job first and get a little bit of money. And I guess then I'm going to have to pay back the mall first. Otherwise, I might go to jail. So, and then I might have to pay back the grocery store for the money that I owe them. But trust me, Squidward, once I pay back both of them, I will be buying you a new window. You broke one of my windows? And then proceeded to disrupt my bath? That's it. Get out. Now. Sorry, buddy, but I just can't leave without that horn. If I don't get that horn back for SpongeBob, he's not going to hang out with me today. I'm going to be bored all day. And then he's going to have work throughout the whole week, and I'm going to have to wait a whole nother week to hang out with him. Sorry, Squidward, but I'm not leaving without that horn. Ugh, how many times do I have to tell SpongeBob before he gets it? Look, I know neither of you can understand since you're not musicians, but not anyone can just start playing music. Especially not either of you two buffoons. The way he was playing that poor French horn. Oh, it was dreadful! I tried to ignore it, but my ears couldn't take it anymore. So I did what any artist would do, and I took the horn away from him. Well, Squidward, I guess that all works out, but... I mean, are you really an artist? I mean, you play the clarinet, but you're not that good. I mean, it's not like you're playing at concerts, or it's not like you have fans, and it's not like you're really rich or anything, so, I mean, excuse me? I may not be performing at concerts or anything, but I'm still pretty good. Here, how about I just prove it to you by playing a song? I know you'll like it. No, Squidward, please, that's more than fine. I don't need to hear you play the clarinet. Please, trust me, I'm good. But anyway, come on, there's got to be some way that SpongeBob can get that French horn back. I mean, if him playing it poorly is what bothered you, I mean, what if he could just get lessons? Then he could learn how to play it well and he wouldn't annoy you anymore. Absolutely not. Even if that fool learned how to properly use it, it would still be really loud. Loud enough to disturb my day off. And no one disturbs my one day off a week. So the answer is no. You know, Squirtard, I wish you were nicer. I mean, you'd be so much easier to deal with, and you'd just be such a better neighbor. It would just be better in every way I could think of. What do you mean? I'm plenty nice. Why, just the other day I ordered a pizza and tipped the delivery driver $1. If that isn't pure kindness, I don't know what is. All right, Squidward, first of all, I'm pretty sure whenever you order a pizza or anything else, you're supposed to tip. And actually, I'm pretty sure you're supposed to tip more than $1, so it sounds like you're just kind of being cheap and selfish. Well, wait a minute. Actually, I was gonna give up, but no, I got a better idea. It solves all of our problems. Why don't I just teach you how to be nice? I mean, I'm sure you can learn, and you're certainly not gonna learn on your own. Oh, and that could take up all day, so I wouldn't be bored today. Oh, Scooter, please, let me teach you how to be nice, please. Heh, why would I ever waste my day off spending it with you? Squidward, because being nice is great. I mean, if you were nicer, you'd probably have more friends, and you'd probably be less miserable all the time, and people would treat you better, and I mean, you'd probably like working at the Krusty Krab a little more, because people would treat you better, and you'd be nicer to the customers. Plus, if you don't come with me and let me teach you how to be nice, I will stay here and annoy you all day, and I mean all day, Squidward, because I got nothing else to do today. So, without further ado, if you're not gonna come and let me train you how to be nice, then... Hey, Squidward. Ah, fine. Just shut up. All right, that is perfect. I knew that would work. All right, well, Squidward, I am just gonna let you finish getting ready there. You can dry off and get changed and whatnot. And whenever you finish getting ready, I will meet you over at the training site. And that is Mrs. Puff's Boating School. Oh, perfect. Looks like SpongeBob's already finished setting everything up. All right, well, Squidward, are you ready to learn how to finally be nice? It's about time, don't you think? Oh, perfect. Looks like SpongeBob's already finished setting everything up. All right, Squidward. Well, are you ready to finally learn how to be nice to people? I think it's about time, if I do say so myself. I guess. But why are we doing this at Mrs. Puff's Boating School? Because, Squidward, school is where you're supposed to learn how to be nice. And apparently, you missed that lesson at school. So, I figured we might as well do it here at Mrs. Puff's Boating School. And I tried to do it inside the classroom, so it'd be a little bit more, schooly. But it was a little cramped in there, so I decided to take it outside for recess. Alright, well, I guess I'm ready. What am I going to learn first? Alright, I think first thing you should learn is... how about how to smile? See, Squidward, smiling when talking to someone is a good indication of whether or not you actually want to talk to them. And it's also going to show how you feel that you're talking to them. See, Squidward, if I am talking to someone, like, let's say I'm talking to SpongeBob right here, but instead of smiling, like he is right there, let's say I'm frowning, like that. And I guess, kind of like what you're doing. You look a lot like that left picture, actually, Squidward. It's not a good thing. But, anyway, let's say I'm talking to SpongeBob, and I have a frown on my face, right? I'm not looking happy, and I'm talking to him. He's going to think that I don't want to talk to him, and he's going to think that I'm not having a good day. But, on the contrary, I am having a fantastic day, because it's Sunday, and I'm just chilling, and I'm teaching you how to be nice, and I'm here with all my friends, and look, Squidward, I don't have to explain why I'm happy today, but I am. So, instead, I am going to smile. And by smiling to SpongeBob, it shows him that, A, I'm having a good day, and B, I enjoy talking to him, and I want to hear more about what he has to say. Now, in this example, I don't actually care what SpongeBob has to say because he's just here to show you what it's like to smile. You know, a proper example of someone who's always smiling and someone who's always friends with everyone and is always being treated well by people. Probably because he smiles. At least part of that. So, Squidward, what I want to see you try to do is instead of looking like that guy right there, I want you to look like that guy. And smile! Come on, show me those pearly whites, Squidward. Okay. Alright, I see that smiling is not your forte. It's okay, we can go back to that one later. How about instead, we work on... Ooh, okay, here's one. Sharing. Now, sharing is something you're supposed to learn at school, along with being nice, but apparently you didn't really learn that, Squidward. So, I'm going to teach to you right here, right now. So, Squidward, sharing is obviously a very important part of being a good person. So, let's say I have these 5 candy canes here. Now, you would probably take these 5 candy canes and have them all for yourself. But if you want to make some more friends, Squidward, and you want people to like you a bit more, and you want to just be overall happier and more positive, you got to learn how to share with people. So, these 5 candy canes, I'm going to share a few with you, Squidward. And these eggs, oh yes, I can make some omelets with them, I can make some nice scrambled eggs, but wouldn't it be better if I could make some scrambled eggs with you? Huh? Yeah? Uh-huh. And then carrots, let's say I want to, you know, add it to my dinner, but I want to have a nice deal with you, Squidward. I don't want to just have a nice lonely dinner, because that would be sad. So I want to give you a few of these carrots as well. And diamonds, because, you know, it doesn't have to just be food, Squidward. I'm going to share some diamonds with you, because I'm a nice guy, okay? Now, Krabby Patties are a little bit different. I do want to share these with you, because I'm trying to be a good person. But these are really hard to share. And I don't blame you if there are certain things that you don't really like sharing. Some things you're not really supposed to share. But everything is meant to be shared at least a little bit, I say. So, you know what? There, Squidward, have a Krabby Patty. And the rest are going to be for me. But anyway, you know, you can actually have everything else. I'm going to share with you everything else, Squidward, except for these Krabby Patties, because I really don't want to share these with you. But other than that, that is how to share. And all right, so we've gotten through how to smile, how to share. Okay, here's next part. I'm going to show you some different things that you shouldn't be saying to people, Squidward. Now, these 9 signs right here are all things that you have said at one point or another, and they're all very negative and mean and just things that we're trying to avoid here at nice school, okay? So, let's see. You're ugly. You don't want to say that, Squidward. I know you said that to me a lot, but I don't want you saying it to me anymore, okay? You look like a blob of pink ice cream. I think you were also saying that to me as well, and I did not think it was very nice. Get out of my house before I call the police. Again, not very nice, Squidward. You were trying to get me out of your house instead of inviting me and making me a meal or something. So, not good. No, I don't want to play with you. Bad, Squidward. I hate my job. Bad. Stop ruining my day off. Go away. You suck. And, last but certainly not least, you smell bad. All of these are very negative and mean, Squidward, and if you want to be a nicer person, you should try to say nicer things and use nicer words. Like, these 9 signs say right here. Now, instead of these 9 signs being all negative and mean, these 9 signs are very nice and will make people feel good about themselves. Alright? So if you want to make some friends, try using some of these lines, Squidward. How about, have a nice day. You look great today. I love you. I'm glad to see you. You smell wonderful. You're my best friend. How are you today? You're so funny. Sure, you can have some fries. I guess I wrote that when I was thinking about the sharing thing. But it still works, okay? So, anyway, Squidward, now that I've taught you how to share, how to smile, and some nicer things to say, yeah, don't look at any of these 9 things right here. Just look at the good signs, okay? Just look at the positive ones. Now that I've taught you how to be nice, I'm going to show you with a demonstration. So, there's a guy right here, and I'm going to have a nice, proper conversation with him. One where I'm very nice to him, and hopefully he is nice to me back. So, here's how you start. Let me try using one of these openers, actually. How about, I'm glad to see you. Hello, sir. I'm glad to see you today. Why, hello to you, too, good sir. How are you on this wonderful day? Well, sir, I am doing fantastic. And may I just say, you... let me think about one of these other ones I can use. Sir, let me just say, you smell wonderful. Oh, thank you. You're too kind. And may I just say that you look great today. Fantastic fashion sense. Huh. Oh, these green trousers? Oh, come on, I wear these every day. You're too kind. Please, sir, let me repay you for your kind words by cooking you a meal at my place Friday night. Please, I insist. Oh, that sounds splendid. I'll be sure to bring my wife. Heck, I can even bring a few dishes to spruce up the meal a bit. My wife makes some delicious guacamole. Oh, of course. I'm sure it's delicious. Please, please, bring your wife and bring as many dishes as you want. Please, I insist. Oh, perfect. Have a fantastic day and see you Friday. Oh, please, sir, I hope you have a fantastic day as well. I will see you Friday, and I can't wait to meet your wife. I'm sure she's lovely. All right, Squidward. Well, that, my friend, is how you have a polite, kind conversation. And talking to a guy that I've never met before, now we are good pals, and we're going to have dinner on Friday, apparently. So I'm probably going to have to learn how to cook. Or I guess this is just a demonstration, so I guess we don't really have to make dinner for him on Friday. But anyway, that was everything that I had to show you about being nice, Squidward. So I want to see you try now. First off, I want to see you smile. Okay, all right. Okay, I guess you can still work on that. And how about work on sharing? How about you try giving me some of those things back that I gave you? Okay, okay. You're working on that still. Okay, I get it. But at the very least, it looked like you were learning a lot from the conversation demonstration that I was doing over there. So, Squidward, I think we're going to get as far as we possibly can trying to make you nice, okay? So, without further ado, SpongeBob, you think he's ready to test? Oh, yeah, you think he's ready? Okay, well then, Squidward, it's time to test your new niceness by taking you to the park. Oh, sweet, the Bikini Bottom Park is finally done. I know they've been meaning to add one of these for a while, but I must say, it really did come together well. I mean, Bikini Bottom is so sandy and so spread out. I think it's nice that we have just a nice chill, you know, nice and green park right here. We got a nice fountain. We have some benches in case I want to sit down and just chill. We got some nice trees around here, which Bikini Bottom is severely lacking, I must say. We got a nice entrance. Oh, this place is just perfect. And it's also a perfect place to talk to people. Hey, Squidward. Hey there, buddy. Well, thank you for meeting me here. What are we doing at the park? I thought you were supposed to test my training. Exactly, Squidward. The park is the perfect place to talk to people. I mean, look around. There's people everywhere. And they're going to be at the park, so they're going to be nice and relaxed and in a good mood. Definitely willing to talk to people. What? But the only people I see here are kids. Yeah, you're right. I do see a lot of kids. Oh, what about that one girl sitting on the bench over there? Oh, no, not her. Oh, she's way too cute. I can't do it. Squidward, come on, buddy. You gotta believe in yourself here, okay? This isn't the old grumpy Squidward, okay? Even though you're frowning right now. This isn't the old grumpy Squidward. This is the new and improved nice Squidward. The kind of Squidward that any girl would love to talk to and have a nice chat with, okay? So, I know that girl is kind of cute, but she's sitting over there all alone, and she looks like she wants to talk to someone. So, you could be that guy, Squidward. So, here's what I want you to do, okay? I want you to turn that frown upside down, give me a nice smile, and then I want you to go over there and just start talking to her. Have a nice, pleasant conversation with her. Ask her how her day is going, or what her name is, or what she's doing at the park. I don't know. I can't do it all for you, Squidward. You gotta do some of it for yourself. But, you know, just smile, talk with a nice tone, say good words, not your usual words like you suck and you smell and stuff like that. No, try to keep it positive, try to keep it light, and just have fun with it, okay? So, good luck, Squidward. Hi there. What's your name? Well, hello, handsome. My name's Lauren. What's yours? Did you say, handsome? Squidward. My name's Squidward. And, let me just say that I think you're beautiful. Aw, thank you very much. Do you come to the park often? No, work keeps me pretty busy. And when I'm not working, I'm playing my clarinet. Ooh, you play the clarinet? I love music. Do you think you could play it for me sometime? Absolutely. Maybe I could bring it to the park one day and play for you. That sounds wonderful. How about Tuesday after you finish work? That'd be perfect. And it'd be close to dinner time, so I'll pack a nice dinner for us to share. How romantic. All right, well, sounds like a plan. See you then, Squidward. See you then. Have a nice day. Man, Squidward is sure taking his sweet time talking to that girl. I hope he at least gets a date or something with her at this point. He's gonna take this long. Oh, hey, Squidward. Oh, looks like you're done. So, how'd it go?
That felt great, actually. Usually when I talk to girls, they just give me a weird look and walk away. She actually seemed to like me.
Well, Squirtle, I gotta tell you, maybe it's because you smiled and talked to her nicely for a change, huh? You know, usually you're just frowning and being your old squiddy self, but now that you're nice, maybe that was the difference maker.
You know what? I think you're right. My whole life I've been mean because I thought it wasn't worth the effort to be nice, but now I'm starting to rethink that. I mean, maybe my life would be a lot less miserable if I were nice. People would treat me better, I'd have more friends. You know what? That's it. No more mean, grouchy Squidward. From here on out, I vow to be nicer and more positive.
Well, Squidward, I gotta tell you, that's great to hear. I gotta tell you, it really is a matter of time. I mean, I wish you had started being nicer a long time ago. It would have made a lot of things simpler, but I guess now that you're nice, it doesn't really matter. So, anyway, who are you gonna start being nicer to first? You do have a lot of people that you've treated pretty poorly over the years, you know?
Well, first I have to start with you and SpongeBob. Probably the two people I've treated the worst.
Just thinking about all the things I've done and said to you makes me feel terrible.
I'm sorry, Jack. You're a good friend, and you deserve to be treated well.
Don't worry about it, buddy. I know you've changed your ways. I know you're not the mean guy you used to be. I gotta tell you, though, you should be apologizing to SpongeBob. I mean, he was really looking forward to practicing that French horn earlier, and you took it away from him. But he's pretty bummed.
You're right. And that's why as soon as I get home, I'm going to give SpongeBob's French horn back. Then, I'm going to go apologize to all the people that I've treated poorly over the years. Which I guess includes everyone in Bikini Bottom. But you know what? It'll be worth it. Because now I can be friends with everyone and stop being lonely. Oh, I'm so happy. Thank you, Jack. Really, you've done more than you know, pal.
Alright, Squirtle. Well, hey, I'm glad to help. And I gotta tell you, You occupied my whole day that was otherwise going to be pretty boring and was probably going to involve me just sitting around doing nothing. So I'm glad I got to do a little community service, if you will, today. But anyway, Squirter, now it's starting to get a little bit late, and I think a Krabby Patty has my name on it over at the Krusty Krab. Oh, except I don't have any money right now. All right, well, I guess I'll just go home instead. Yeah, you know what? Yeah, I think SpongeBob is on shift tomorrow. I think he can make me one tomorrow for lunch.
Alright, well, I guess then for now I'll just go home. See you, Squidward. Have fun with that girl.
Ugh, finally I can get a Krabby Patty. Oh, it's been days since I've had one. Oh, I'm so hungry.
Wait a minute, is that... No, that can't be... Could it? It looks like Plankton and Warren... Isn't that the girl Squidward was talking to the other day at the park? And it looks like they're having... picnic of some kind. With cake, too. What the heck is going on here? Plankton, what's going on?
What? I'm just having a lovely picnic.
But you're with the girl Squidward is talking to. I don't get it.
Oh, is it?
Well, that's too bad. Because it looks like she's on a date with me.
Oh, wow. Well, this is unexpected. Well, what about Karen? I mean, I know she's just a computer, but isn't she like your wife or your girlfriend or something?
Yeah, she's been a handful lately. When I offered to make us a picnic, she said no because she can't eat any of the food.
Ah, computer girlfriends, am I right?
No, I've never really had a computer girlfriend before, Plankton, so I guess I can't really relate with you there, but...
Yeah, man, that is the same girl.
Huh. Well, apparently she's on a date with Plankton instead. Oh, there's Squidward. Huh. I gotta go ask him what's going on here. Squidward, buddy! I just saw Plankton having a date with that girl you met at the park the other day. What's going on?
I'll tell you what happened. Plankton stole Warren away from me.
What? But I thought you guys had a date planned in the park, and you were going to play the clarinet for her, and you guys were going to have a picnic and everything.
Well, she came by here earlier and told me that our picnic date in the park was canceled because she just met a guy that she was more interested in. And that guy was Plankton.
Really? She chose Plankton over me? But I'm so much taller than him.
Yeah, that is kind of strange, Squidward. I mean... I didn't really hear your guys' conversation, but, I mean, from what she said, it sounded like it went pretty well.
Yeah, well, apparently she's into bad boys. She said, "Sorry, I really like you, Squidward, but you're just too nice for me. I need someone more dark and mysterious. Like Plankton. I mean, he's always trying to steal the formula and put the Krusty Krab out of business. So hot. Huh. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Squirtard. I guess you used the wrong tactic then, huh? Turning nice? Oh, well. You know, I'm sure you're going to meet someone else, Squirtard. I mean, now that you're a nice guy, I mean, not all girls are going to be like that. You know, you're going to meet another girl, and you're going to use your nice personality to woo over. I'm sure of it. Heh. I don't think so, you idiot. I've officially gone back to being mean, Squidward. What? But no, Squirtard, we made so much progress turning you nice. Well, if being nice can't get me dates with cute girls, then what's the point? Sorry, Jack. I know you tried to help, but I'm just a grumpy squid at heart. Nothing can change that. Wait, why am I saying sorry? I meant to say... Ha! You barnacle-head! You actually thought you could make me nice? Yeah, right! Now, get out of here before I call the cops for you breaking and entering into my house! Oh, well, Squirtard, I'm really sorry to hear that. And I'm actually... I kind of believe your threat, actually, so I'm just gonna get out of here, right now. Sorry for breaking your window. I'll pay you back one of these days, Squidward!